For more latest news from the sports multiverse, please like, share and subscribe The Bridge and hit the bell icon to never miss a notification.
Hello and welcome to yet another episode of Oh My Olympic Guys. But this particular episode is a bit more special than the others. I'll tell you why, because the way yesterday has ended and the way today has started, these particular days are going to last longer than just the span of 24 hours. And to talk about this, I welcome the one and only Gurbakht Singh to our very special episode. And I'm just going to quickly introduce, he is the jewel of that crown of Indian hockey who has brought glories to the nation. He has been the part of that team who won a gold in 1964 Tokyo Olympics. It could be a coincidence, right? And thank you so much for coming to our episode, sir. I'm just going to start with a very generic question. How happy you are today?
I couldn't have been more happy than what I am today. From yesterday's win and the men's win and today's women's win, I think most unexpected today's win. But I think they have surprised and they have gone beyond their expectations themselves. And I think they have done wonders for the Indian hockey and for the women's hockey for us. I think this is a wonderful day for Indian hockey.
Definitely, sir. And do you think these very important, significant wins can again bring hockey back to the confines of India?
Yeah, sure, it will. Because you see, now the door for the medals have opened for both the teams. You see, they have both are capable of now, they're going to play two matches each. First is the semi-final. And if we win the semi-final, We are on for the silver and gold. And if we lose, suppose the team loses, then again the door for the bronze is also still open. So I think this has particularly happened with the tenacity and the hard work done by both the teams for the last few years. And I think this is going to benefit Indian hockey in all, and particularly the women's hockey a lot, because women's hockey has not been in the pink of health for long. You see, it is now in resurgence. And I think they'll do better and better. More girls will come and play hockey. And I think it's going to benefit hockey a lot.
Definitely, sir. Especially the fact that almost 50% of both of the teams are debutants. The way those who have first time played Olympics are performing, it's incredible. Yeah, and yeah, sure. if you talk about their performances before Olympics, do you think that performances gave up just that, yes, Indian hockey can do something incredible this time in Olympics?
No, first of all, it was a very pleasant surprise that the Indian women hockey team qualified, and that was, we thought, was ultimate. But then to qualify for the semifinals, I think it was another, and the quarterfinal for the quarterfinals. And then to win the quarterfinal and go to the semifinal, I think it has been an incredible journey for the Indian women's hockey team. Men's, I was expecting, yes, they are capable, because in any case, they were number 4 in the world ranking. And I was expecting them. We have been so far and so near for the last few Olympics, like in Sydney, it should have happened. Then in Los Angeles, it should have happened. So I think we have missed what so many times. I was expecting them to do well. But women have surprised everybody, and pleasant surprise for the whole country.
Exactly. So, I mean, 40 years, almost four decades, and India literally missed this glory. And do you think it's again reviving somewhere? Do you think, this is the
team? Yeah, 49 years, in fact, to be precise. Semi-final played in 1972. Mm. And then 80, there were only 6 teams there. And we are the first 2 teams qualified for the final. Spain and India. Yeah. And I think the real qualification came now. And this is the time, and we missed so many times, as I said earlier, that we missed it in Sydney, we missed it in Los Angeles by one match, just by a whisker. You see, because in Sydney, I was present there in 2000. And we were winning by 1 goal against Poland, and then we drew the match in the last minute. Spain, Poland scored the equalizer, and we could not qualify. And I think the team has done very well. And they have really played well, and I'm sure that they're going to do well tomorrow also, the men's team and the day after the women's team.
Yeah. I mean, see, people like me and all of the ordinary people who do not understand the exact technicalities of hockey, but I mean, if it's coming from you who understand hockey very much, and like you have been to that golden time of Indian hockey where India was unbeatable, and it's coming from you, I think it means a lot for their performances as well. So what are your exactly takeaways from both of these matches? What exactly led them to success?
I think they played within their limits. They knew their weaknesses. They knew their strong points. India came back after losing to Australia by 7-1. 1-7, they lost to Australia.
Yeah.
The men's team.
Yeah.
And then they came back slowly. Because let's understand that pool matches are different. Ball games and knockout are different. Because pool matches are played, even if you lose one game, you're always in. You're supposed, you can hope to win the next two matches and then be and qualify in the first four. So it's not a big thing. But once it comes to knockout, then every team, even the strongest team, is very careful. And they are actually, the heart is in their mouth, because they know that if they one goal goes against them, if they are not able to equalize. The same thing happened to Australia today. They were down in the first pool and the first period, and after that they could not come back. So it's very, very important. So I think now India's got every good chance to also go to the finals also.
So do you think it might be because, one of the factors, there are 1,000 others, but I'm just predicting that this could be a factor that maybe they do not have the pressure on them to perform. That's why they just perform to prove themselves that we have to do it for us.
I agree with you. See, I'm not, I don't want to compare the individual, but at the same time, you see the pressure on the shooters and the archery.
Yeah.
How much pressure they were in. You see, because you're world champion, you're world champion there, you're world number one there. You see, so it counts. It also definitely, men's team, more expectations were there. But women's team played with flair and they are able to perform. And I'm sure that they play with the same flair, not thinking about the result. They should play their game, what they played today, and I'm sure they will perform well and the result will be in our favor.
All right. So there has been, say, when we talk about Hockey India, and like there has been a same batch of people who have been there with the team for ages now. So when we're talking about the coaches, Graham Reed and Sajjad, they have been there with the team no matter what, in their bats and in their best right now. So I was just wondering, do you think the idea of foreign coaches have worked well for India?
I think it's good. You see, unless we come up with the same strategy and we come up to the same standard, it's not the question of a player. The Indian players are going to be good catchers. Earlier, it was different. Today, it's the technology coming with a lot. And it's the whole team. It's not only the coach alone. It is also the physio. It is also the psychologist. It is also the machines working. That each player, how is heartbeat doing? And every 2 minutes, 3 minutes. Can you imagine in a 60-minute match, there are 60 to 80 changes in a match. 60 to 80 times, the players are changed. So just imagine where the technology has taken the game. And I think it's important that we are able to, if our coaches can come to the same standard, I've got no problem. I think I'll prefer Indian coaches. But at the same time, if we're getting results from the foreign coaches, why should we, others have worked with this thing. And Australian coaches are doing very well even in Belgium and other places also.
Yeah.
So I think let's understand that if other games, now the grass game was different. Grass hockey was different. Aspect of hockey is different. Today's hockey is different. Rules have changed. So it's quite different ball game. And I think it's, let's not go into that. I think changing coaches has also been a bad thing for Indian hockey. But now since these people have been continuing and they have shown the result, and I'm sure that they will improve better.
Definitely. There were predictions. I mean, the way boys were performing even before the Olympics started. So somewhere it was inevitable that they are going to achieve this feat. If not in this Olympics, maybe next. But the fact is, women's team jumped out of nowhere. So how do you see the success of women's team?
I think great. I think they have begun, as I said earlier, they have proved themselves and they have improved with every match. What they played earlier, they gave a shock to everybody, a present shock. to what they played today, what they performed today. And they were on equal terms with Australian. And I think they deservedly won this match. And in fact, Rani's goal should have been hit the post. They also missed a few chances.
Yeah.
But they were expected to do well. Australia were expected to do well. They're definitely a better placed team and better structured team. But our team played on equal terms. And that is a great, great thing. Winning or losing apart, I think it's a great thing for Indian hockey that they can come physically also, mentally also, and also psychologically. I think they have proved themselves, and I think this will stand in good stead to the Indian girls in future also. And in future, the girls will go with their head held high when they go, and they can fight with equal terms with any foreign team.
Definitely. And as far as the fitness of especially Indian women team is concerned, it has been very much evident how hard those girls have worked. And okay, so since we are already in semifinals, and you've already mentioned that if we lose the match, yes, we can bring the bronze. So just to reconfirm, sir, do you think India can bring a medal home? Do you think hockey is coming home this
time? Now I've got every hope. Earlier, I was saying about the men's team, but I have got now hope for both the teams. Both the teams can bring the medal home. Why not? Because the way they have performed today, and I'm sure they are going to, because now they will have a double confidence. How they went today, now they will go that, yes, we can do it. And that is the big thing in sport. You see, once you have this feeling that I can do it, and I think you get double the energy and you are able to prove that. And I think it's very, very important for the team.
Yeah, so I read somewhere in the interview about how how the hockey team of your time used to perform. You guys just used to go out there on the field and like, humse behtar koi nahi hai. So I think that this is one of the most important factors that Indian hockey should carry today.
You see, thing is, earlier when the India-Pakistan used to go on the field, the Europeans knew, Europeans and Australians and New Zealanders knew that they were scared of us. You see, they thought that they can't beat us. You see, and we were ashamed. We knew that we can beat them. Now it has come to opposite. Now the European field felt that men and women team, they can beat Indian team. But from today or from yesterday, now they will understand. Now our teams will have that confidence that yes, we are capable to win these matches. And that's very important. That confidence, not overconfidence, but confidence is very important in sport, that I can do it. And I think that gives the double the energy to the team to perform well.
Yeah, I think that's something which went wrong for Australia today, because I read it in a post-match report, like how confident Australians were, but they had no idea what to hit them. And then, now we have to talk about Savita and Srijesh. We have to talk about them because Savita saved almost like 12 shots today from Australia. And how important Srijesh and Savita is for the Indian team.
Yeah,
right?
They have been. In fact, I believe that they have been the strong point for Indian hockey, for the Indian team. No doubt the scoring is very important. You only win if you score goals. But at the same time, if you don't concede goals, I will give credit to the whole team. It's not Savita alone, it's not Srijesh alone, it's not the forwards alone who have scored, but the whole team as a team, they stand and they work together and they win. And I think that's very important. The result counts. And it's one of the, somebody has to stand out. And I give credit to Savita today that she stood out and she played well and India carried the day.
Yeah, I mean, the thing is that both of them are those veterans who have seen India, who have seen India's downfall, and now they're actually building upon that. So, yeah. Okay, so I mean, men teams, as far as men teams is concerned, they have performed pretty well in pro league performances. Do you think those performances gave away a glimpse that, yes, Indian men's hockey team is going to do something big in the Olympics?
Yeah, definitely. Definitely, because they have been playing well for the last few years. The same team has been playing, same players have been playing. Earlier in the pool matches, it was the penalty corner. It was Harmanpreet and it was they were scoring goals. And in the knockout stage, you see, it was three forwards who scored the goals. I think it's very, very important that the whole team is now joining in the party. I think it's very important. And that is what should happen. Now, I hope that tomorrow both the forwards as well as the penalty corner specialists both join the party and we come out flying with flying colors. That's what I expect. Let's hope for the best.
Yes, definitely, sir. Because, like, again, I said that some, if it's coming from an ordinary person like me, that yes, I mean, I'm just hoping, but it's coming from you, because, but you know the game best, okay? And when it's coming from you, it just, you know, elevates our hope. That's all. It literally does that. So I was just wondering, like, yes, we have actually set a benchmark right now in Tokyo Olympics. And where do you think India's future will pan out after this? Indian hockey.
I think the resurgence of Indian hockey, which had gone down for the last, as we understand, 75 was the last genuine World Cup what we won. That was on grass. And 80 was many teams did not play, but we won. All the same, we have gold medals. After that, it has been down. We have seen the downfall of Indian hockey. And again, it is resurgence. And I think it will give a big boost to the Indian hockey in the men's and now, with this win in the women, I think women's hockey will also come back, come with the double the vigor and resurgence, because many more girls will come to play hockey. I think it will be important. The whole country will now wake up. Earlier, the women's hockey was thought to be just to go there and play. And I think now it's important that people will give importance to Indian hockey also.
Definitely. I mean, you know what? I mean, when I say this, okay, so yesterday Sindhu also brought a medal home, okay? And yesterday Indian men's hockey, they bagged a match to semifinal. They booked their place in semifinals. I'll tell you what, sir. Both of the contents were out. And literally, when I say this, we have seen the most surge in, I mean, our audiences have given more attention to Indian men hockey. I mean, even though Sindhu, I mean, not comparing or downgrading anyone.
When
I say this, that yes, India loves hockey, India still loves hockey, because the reaction from the audience was very overwhelming and unpredictable, believe me. So yeah, yes, true. They love hockey.
Yeah. It has been our vision. See, the thing is, it is the first vision. Why I started playing hockey? Because when I was born, at that time, Dhyan Chand was our hero. You know, so all those things. So because they were gold medals, you could participate in the Olympics only because of hockey. So that is why how it was happening. And now I'm happy that other sports are also coming up. That Sindhu and Mary Kom and others have come in. Chennu has come up. But at the same time, in team games, the only game which we can hope for is, unfortunately, football is not doing well. But hockey has been there. It can again come back and we can again be counted where it really counts.
Yes, definitely. And so are we talking about the Federation Hockey Help, Hockey India? How do you think Hockey India as a federation has
They have done very well. Now the money has come in, the tournaments have come in, and the coaches are there. You know, whatever was needed, they have done it. And I'm sure that this is now, that is the result of that the results are paying now. And I think a lot of credit should go to the Hockey India for the last few years. That what they have achieved, what they have done for the Indian hockey, and I think men's and women's hockey, and I'm sure that this will continue. And once the medal comes, I think you will see the again resurgence of Indian hockey.
Yeah, right. So this last question is something that I want to understand. Okay, so after 1980s. You yourself mentioned that India has seen a downfall of Indian hockey, which was very, I mean, it was literally a steep down. Why do you think this happened? I mean, just trying to understand.
I tell you, because of the 80s, after in the 76, the AstroTurf came in. And our Indian Hockey Federation, our officials, our government, our players, they did not take it that AstroTurf hockey and grass hockey are two different ball games. So this was took us 20 years to understand. We still thought that we'll play the same or Dhyan Chand style hockey or Claudius or Balbir Singh or Gurbakhsh Singh hockey, which was not possible. This is a different ball game. Rules have changed. You see, the turf has changed, ground has changed, everything has changed. You see, now it's more like football controlling the game. You see, like football, you have to control the game. So surface is there. And we did not have sufficient surfaces for more than 20-25 years. 20-25 years, we hardly 4, 5, 6 services in the whole country, which was not enough. Whereas in a city like Holland, there were 100 astroturfs at that time. We India had total five. So that it took us time. So that 20 years we wasted. Oh, that 20 years we wasted.
It's okay.
Somebody phoning up.
Yeah.
That 20 years we wasted. And I think that is one of the reasons why it happened. You see, and then now after that, the resurgence has come slowly, slowly it has taken. We had gone down to last in the London Olympics. We finished last in the 12th.
Yeah.
In the 12th. So, and then one Olympic, we did not qualify. We had come to that bad stage. Now it has come back again. So in 8-10 years, now we are again coming back. And I think now it will stay there. And now it will only go up and up.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, I don't think so. It could get any worse than that. Like 2016 Rio, I don't think so it could get worse than that. And Indian hockey has to build from here. And that's all for the interview, sir. Thank you.
Thank you.
What an honor. Thank you so much for taking this interview, sir. It's such an
honor.
Yeah. Please take care. Thank you.
Bye. Thank you. Bye.
Thank you so much for watching this episode, guys. I hope you fan, I don't know. You literally had a fandom on him, just like I did. What an amazing person to have a bird with on such an incredible day. If you liked the video, do not forget to click on like, share, subscribe. Click on the bell icon to never miss a notification from the Bridge. Thank you for watching this video. Take care.